For the following, find the square roots. All of these are principal square roots, which means in each case we ask what non-negative number times itself is equal to the number under the square root called the radicand. So to simplify the square root of 4, we ask ourselves what non-negative number times itself is equal to 4. Well, 4 is equal to 2 times 2, which equals 2 squared, and therefore the square root of 4 is equal to 1 factor of 2. By writing the radicand as a perfect square, we can also think of the square root as undoing the squaring, leaving us with the base. So the square root of 4 is equal to 2 because 2 squared equals 4. Next, we have the square root of 100. So we're asking what non-negative number times itself is equal to 100. So the square root of 100 is equal to the square root of 10 squared, which simplifies to 1 factor of 10. The square root of 100 is equal to 10 because 10 squared equals 100. For C, we have the square root of 36. So we're asking what non-negative number times itself is equal to 36. Well, 36 is equal to 6 times 6, or 6 squared, and therefore the square root of 36 simplifies to 1 factor of 6. Again, because 6 squared equals 36. Next, we have the square root of 121. 121 is equal to 11 times 11, and therefore the square root of 121 equals the square root of 11 squared, which equals 1 factor of 11. The square root of 121 equals 11. Next, we have the square root of 2,500. So we're looking for a non-negative number times itself equal to 2,500. In this case, the radicand is quite large. When we have a large radicand, looking at the prime factors of the radicand can be helpful when simplifying square roots. In this case, let's write 2,500 as 25 times 100. And notice that 25 and 100 are both perfect squares. 25 is equal to 5 times 5. 100 equals 10 times 10. We can actually stop here because notice how 5 times 10 is 50 here, and 5 times 10 is 50 here. So now we know 2,500 is equal to 50 times 50. So the square root of 2,500 equals the square root of 50 squared, which equals 1 factor of 50. Next, we have the square root of 0. So again, we're looking for a non-negative number times itself equal to 0. Well, the square root of 0 is equal to the square root of 0 squared, which simplifies to 1 factor of 0. Next, we have the square root of 400. Let's look at the factors of 400. 400 is equal to 4 times 100. 4 is equal to 2 times 2. 100 equals 10 times 10. If we stop here, notice how we have two factors of 20. 2 times 10 is 20 here, as well as here, which means you can write 400 as 20 times 20. So the square root of 400 is equal to the square root of 20 squared, which equals 1 factor of 20. H is pretty straightforward because 3 squared is equal to 9. So to show some work, the square root of 9 equals the square root of 3 squared, which equals 1 factor of 3. And now for the last example, we have the square root of a fraction, but notice how 64 is equal to 8 times 8, and 49 is equal to 7 times 7. So we can write this as the square root of 64 49ths equals the square root of 8 sevenths squared. Again, 8 squared equals 64, 7 squared equals 49, and therefore this simplifies to one of the factors, or the base, of 8 sevenths. I hope you found this helpful.